In this video, I'm going to provide a high-level overview of the main steps needed to install and initially configure a DXi4700-Series system. Step 1. Plan the installation site. Before you start the installation, obtain and read the site planning guide and the installation and configuration guide for your DXi system. Download copies of each guide from the Quantum Support website or the customer self-service portal. The DXi requires a standard 4-post 19-inch server rack. You'll need to obtain at least one static IP address for the DXi and open various firewall ports when configuring network settings during the installation. Refer to the site planning guide for detailed information on IP address requirements and firewall ports. Step 2. Prepare the tools and hardware. You don't need any special tools to install the rack mounting rails. However, you'll need a large flathead screwdriver if you want to adjust the location of the rails within the rack. You also need a notebook computer and an Ethernet cable to perform the initial system configuration. The DXi system contains static-sensitive parts. Make sure to take appropriate ESD precautions when handling hardware components to avoid damaging them. One example is to wear an anti-static wristband when handling hardware components. Unpack the DXi components and packaging materials by following the procedures in the installation and configuration guide. Verify that you have all the components in the shipment. DXi systems come in several different configurations. Base configurations are a single node with no additional components required. Some systems are shipped with one or more expansion modules and with components that you must install in the node. Refer to the Installation Overview section in the Installation and Configuration Guide for details about system configurations. Step 3. Install components in the node. Depending on the configuration of your DXi system, you may need to install additional hard drives, memory modules, and interface cards in the node. Place the node on an ESD-protected work surface to install these components. This video shows only a high-level overview of the process, so be sure to read and follow the step-by-step instructions in the Installing Components in the Node section of the Installation and Configuration Guide. Install the supplied additional 6 hard drives. If your system has components to install inside the node, remove the node top cover and the cooling shroud. If your system requires additional memory, remove the fan assembly and install the supplied 8 or 16 memory modules. Then replace the fan assembly. If your system has expansion modules, you must install the RAID controller card. You should do this without removing the riser from the node. If you are installing the optional 10 GBASE-T Ethernet card, it must be installed in slot 4, which is the top slot in the middle riser. If you are installing the full-height optical or TwinAx card, install it in slot 4 in the same manner. If you are installing the half-height optical or TwinAx Ethernet card, it must be installed in slot 1. Install this card by removing the riser, installing the card in the riser, then reinstalling the riser in the node. If you ordered the optical configuration, Insert an SFP Plus unit into each 10 gigabit Ethernet port on the optional Ethernet card. Inspect all areas where you have installed components to verify nothing is pinched or out of place. Then replace the cooling shroud. Last, replace the node top cover. Now you are ready to install the system in a rack. Step 4. Install the system in a rack. Follow the step-by-step instructions in the installation and configuration guide to install the rack mounting rails and chassis in the rack. Be aware that installing your DXi system too high in an empty rack could cause the rack to become unstable. Installing the system in a lower area of an empty rack is recommended. The rack in this example contains components in the lower area, so the system will be installed in the upper half. Due to the weight of the system components, two people are required to lift the expansion modules or the node when installing them in the rack mounting rails. When inserting the node into its rails, make sure that the rail standoffs on each side of the node chassis are properly seated into the rail J slots. Step 5. Connect the SAS and fiber channel cables. Follow the instructions in the installation and configuration guide to complete the cabling at the back of your DXi system. If your system includes expansion modules, connect the SAS cables to those modules. If your system is configured for VTL, connect the fiber channel cables. Do not connect any Ethernet cables at this time. Step 6. Connect the power cables. Connect the power cables to the expansion modules and the node. Do not connect any Ethernet cables at this time. At the rear of each expansion module, switch on the module power and wait 30 seconds for the modules to start up. For clarity, the power cables are not shown here. Return to the front of the unit and press the power button on the node to start the system. It can take up to 30 minutes for the system to completely start up. Step 7. Complete the Getting Started wizard. After the system powers on, return to the back of the unit and connect your notebook computer to Ethernet port 1. Follow the procedure in the installation and configuration guide to configure the notebook computer. Log into the system as the administrator. The default password is password. The Getting Started wizard will walk you through the steps shown at the top of the screen. First, you'll need to read and accept the license agreement. Next, the Access Control page asks you for new passwords for the GUI administrator and SSH CLI service accounts. You must provide new passwords in order to proceed. Now you can configure the network settings. Be sure to consult with a network administrator about the general settings. Keep in mind that the installation and configuration guide provides just one network configuration example, which is a non-bonded, single interface with one IP address. The DXi includes many additional networking features and options to meet the needs of most environments. These settings can be modified at any time in the future as needs change. To configure a non-bonded, single interface, display the Bonding Details section by clicking Show. Then select all Ethernet ports in the Not Bonded row. In the IP address table, select the ETH1 interface and enter the IP address information. Then select Any to allow all traffic types on the interface. Then click Next. You'll also need to configure the date and time settings for the installation location. After you confirm the system's new settings, click Finish to apply them and the system will reboot. After the system reboots, it's time for a mandatory upgrade to the latest version of the DXi software. If the DXi has an internet connection, use the automatic upgrade process. If the DXi does not have an internet connection, use the manual upgrade process. In either case, follow the upgrade procedure in the installation and configuration guide. Step 8. Connect the Ethernet cables. After the system reboots, disconnect your notebook computer from Ethernet port 1. You can now connect up to 3 Ethernet cables to the network using Ethernet ports 1, 2, and 3. These Ethernet ports are used for remote management, NAS and OST connectivity, as well as replication. In our example, an IP address was configured only for Ethernet port 1, so connecting an Ethernet cable to port 1 is all that's needed. Step 9. Complete the configuration wizards. After the system reboots, enter its IP address in a web browser and log in. You'll see the Configuration Wizards welcome page. These wizards will guide you through configuring NAS, VTL, OST, replication, email alerts, and other key support items. This is one way you can start configuring your system. You can also exit out of the wizards and configure the system using the DXi main menu. Make sure to refer to the DXi User's Guide when configuring any DXi features. You can also refer to the DXi Series configuration videos on the Quantum website. Go to www.quantum.com/DXi4000docs to watch videos on various configuration tasks. As a reminder, when installing a DXi, be sure to read the site planning guide for pre-installation and planning information. Then read the installation and configuration guide for step-by-step installation instructions. You're now ready to integrate the DXi with your backup system and start using it to protect your data.